Hey guys, Coach Mack, playfastfootball.blogspot.com. Today what we're going to do is, we're not going to be doing a video for a blog, we're going to be doing a video that is simply up on my YouTube page for YouTube subscribers, and it's going to be a video that talks about quarterback progressions, a little bit about quarterback footwork, about protection. We're going to talk today about the curl spot flat route. You know, simple curl slide theory. We don't call it curl slide in my offense because the number two receiver doesn't run the slide. He actually runs the spot inside. All right, he runs the check down on a Mike linebacker, and then our number three receiver, who is either a running back or number three in a 3-by-1 set, he's going to run the flat route all the time. The reason we do that is because it keeps simple with my dropback rules. My number three receiver is always a flat protection guy, so he's always a guy that's going to release to the flat. He's always a guy that's going to be hot swing or part of the hot package, the built-in hot throws. So when we're drawing up our dropback concepts, trying to figure out what we want to do, we want to make sure that we don't have too many different rules as an up-tempo team. We want to make sure we don't have too many rules so our guys have to understand, well, this is the combination here, but if I tag it, it's this combination or it's this combination. We want to stay with simple rules and then build some simple tags in to be a little bit more flexible in our passing game, okay? We're going to start off with just curl spot flat. Going to talk a little bit about the routes, going to talk about spacing, going to talk about progression for the quarterback, coverages, and what we're actually looking at. All right, so for us, when we run curl spot flat, okay, what we're going to do is we're going to run, for us, just a simple 10-yard curl by the number one, okay? Make sure the number one has a good split, but not too wide of a split. All right, make sure if you're, let's just talk ball middle of the field right now, he should be inside the numbers slightly when he runs the curl so that the flat route can get leverage to the flat. If the number one takes too wide of a split on the curl, the flat route never gets leverage and the guy hanging in the curl flat, all right, that guy can kind of hang and then drive late. We want to get him out leveraged by the back, so you got to cut down the split of the number one when you're running a curl route. We don't run it off of post stem. We run it as just a 10-yard curl, find a window, okay? Find open grass, take open grass, simple concepts that a lot of coaches use, okay? But we just run it as a 10-yard curl route, all right? Old-fashioned, just 10-yard stop route turning inside. We don't run it off of post stem. Number two is going to run the inside check down. We call it a spot route, and the spot route tells him that he wants to be over, all right, the offensive guard at about 6 yards depth. Okay, so this one's going to be at 10, this one's going to be at about 6. Number one always runs curl, number two always runs spot. Okay, spot route wants to end up somewhere over the outside of the guard, okay, right about where that guard was. All right, we want to occupy that Mike linebacker. Our number three always runs flat control. If he's in the pistol as the tailback, he will motion first. Okay, so if our cadence was ready, set, go, all right, on set, he would motion flat first so that we get him out here by the tackle and we get him moving so that on a snap of the ball, he's full speed, all right, running the swing route. All right, we have to get him full speed wide. We always try and get him to the numbers before he turns up the field because, again, the concept is width. All right, we're trying to get 3-on-2. We're trying to right now get at least 3-on-2, possibly 3-on their Sam and their corner. All right, we'll go through coverages in a minute, but we want to get 3-on-2 somewhere. This is a horizontal, east-west, lateral, all right? It's a route that's about combining or putting a conflict on defenders and trying to get three offensive players on two defenders, okay? So spacing is important, width is important. If this guy doesn't understand how to attack and get width, all right, you run into some problems, okay? You run into some problems here because on when you don't get width, this guy can sit in a curl. Happened to us in a playoff game. This guy sat in the curl, all right, didn't get enough width. He didn't have to hammer to the width. When we threw the curl, he broke from here back inside to get a hand on the curl throw because we didn't do a good job with spacing and our width. On the backside, we're just going to run check down. So he's got a spot, backside post on the backside. We almost never, ever get to the backside progression with our quarterbacks. We are a 1-2-3, okay? We are a 1-2-3 and get out football team in the drop back passing game. Okay, one of the reasons why is last year we only threw drop back passes five, six times a game. There were some games we only threw the ball 10 to 12 times a game. Other games we threw it 19 or 20. But you got to remember, of those 19 or 20, Some of those are three steps, some of those are screens, some of those are play action and bootleg. So even though you're throwing it 19 or 20 times, that doesn't mean you're dropping back five step 19 or 20 times. Okay? So we have to understand within our offense what we're trying to do, what we're trying to accomplish. Okay? So we don't like to progress to the backside. We don't like to use backside side adjust. We like to go 1, 2, 3. Okay? 1, 2, 3. All right? And then get the quarterback back to the line of scrimmage, release, get him up the field, do whatever he's got to do to get us back into positive yards and not take a sack. Okay? So for us right now, 1, 2, 3 is going to be curl 1. Okay? Spot 2. Swing 3. Now, in my opinion, I think the 2s and 3s, okay, the 2s and 3s can in the progression can switch at any time, personally, because if they do something to take the curl away, the ball's going to get thrown off of the next conflict defender, all right, based on how they try to defend it. If the Sam hangs in the curl, okay, if the Sam hangs in the curl, well, then this might be our number 2 option right now, all right? If the Mike expands to the spot, okay, and the Sam were to hang in the curl, we'll go here. Well, if the Sam expands, and in a 4-3 look, you won't really get it, against maybe a, let's say, maybe a 4-4 concept or six-man box or two linebackers in the middle, maybe you get a guy that expands, okay, to the curl, and you get a Mike linebacker that expands past the spot, well, maybe the spot is number 2. So I think those two routes, for me, personally, can be interchangeable between what is your 1-2-3 progression. We always teach our quarterbacks first 1-2-3. Okay? Curl, spot, flat. That's our progression. Okay? Up front, we're going to be a half slide team. So the side that we're throwing the football to, we're going to be a man protection. All right? So he would have 1, he would have 2. All right? Your center is going to go away and set the zone side. So he's got backside A, he's got backside B, he's got backside C. Against this look, 5-man box, 4-3 or 4-2-5, depending on what the look is in the box. We're going to turn it and declare this backer back here as part of the protection. All right, your offensive line will have the 4 down, and that will linebacker in that diagram. That's who we declare as the Mike. Okay, your quarterback will be responsible for play side inside to play side outside linebacker. All right, it's a dual read. All right, for the quarterback, it's a double read. Play side inside linebacker to play side outside linebacker. Okay, now, when teaching your quarterback about protections, when you're a half slide dual read team, very important that your quarterback understands a couple things. Number 1, how many guys are in the protection? Okay, and we teach it very simple to our quarterbacks. If it is a 5-man protection, okay, meaning we're releasing all 5 into the route, and we only have 5 O-linemen in the protection, either one of your linebackers blitzing makes you throw the ball hot, either to the hot spot or the hot swing or the hot flare, okay? If it's a 6-man protection, okay, now both of these linebackers have to blitz in order for you to get the football out of your hand hot, all right? So if it was a 6-man protection, let's say we were in 2-back, and one of the backs is going to stay in and double read with the quarterback, meaning we're going to have a running back that's also responsible for these 2 players. All right? If one of them blitz, the running back can pick up that one. If they both blitz, now it becomes a hot throw. So when teaching your quarterback, it's very important that your quarterback understands, all right, he understands the premise of 5-man protection, either one of my reads make it hot, 6-man protection, both have to blitz to make it hot. Okay, so right now we are in 5-man protection. I'm going to teach my quarterback that if either one of your reads, okay, either one of your reads, all right, blitz, the ball's got to come out hot spot, hot swing, all right, right now. All right, we have to be able to do that and get that understood. Now, here's the thing with blitz protection. If your quarterback can show that he can handle blitzes and get the football out of his hand, even if you're only throwing 2 or 3 yard completions, if he gets the ball out of his hand when they pressure, and he shows that he knows how to handle blitz, they'll stop bringing pressure. If your quarterback sits back there and keeps taking it, all right, and they keep hitting him in the grill, and he looks like he doesn't know where the pressure is coming from or what his protection is, they're going to keep pressuring. So it's very important that you work on with your quarterbacks, all right, doing drills with hot reads and built-in throws so that he can get out of his drop, put a foot in the ground, and throw the ball where it belongs, because that's how you slow up blitz. All right? A lot of people talk about screens and draws. Yeah, we all know that those are other things to slow down the blitz. Okay? But those aren't going to stop the blitz. You're going to have to rip them, okay, for a couple big screens or draws to get them to stop blitzing. In my opinion, one of the ways you get a team to stop blitzing is make sure your quarterback in your O-line knows how to handle a blitz. And if the ball is constantly out of your hand, they won't keep pressuring the quarterback. Because the idea with pressuring the quarterback is getting to him and flustering him, all right, and disrupting his throws. Well, if you blitz and he puts a foot in the ground, when he sees blitz and throws hot spot or hot swing, all right, sooner or later that defensive coordinator is going to look and he's going to say, you know what, we're pressuring. He's in the gun at 5 yards. Every time we bring a backer, he seems to get the ball out of his hand. Maybe we should just cover instead of trying to kill him. So I think it's very important that you go through your different fronts and your reads. What I like to do with my quarterback is have your quarterback on every play, run or pass, three-step or five-step. Have your quarterback come out and say, hey, I've got 52 to 32, 52 to 32. Okay, ready, set. Make your quarterback do that. All right, make your quarterback come out and identify which two he's responsible for and get him to do it on every play. Number one, it's a good teaching method for your quarterback. Number two, it's a good tendency breaker that your quarterback doesn't just come out on drop back and say, hey, I've got these two over here, and on runs, he just sits there and ready, set, go. Okay? Now, let's just talk a little bit, all right? Talk a little bit right now about coverages and things that we're looking at. Right now, I've got drawn up a five-man box, standard two-high safety team, okay? Standard two-high safety team. All right, that could be playing maybe a robber concept or maybe a quarters type concept. All right, first thing I teach my quarterbacks with two high safeties, we're going to look at leverage of the corners first. That's going to tell us a bunch about the coverage. Two high safeties with the corners under 5 yards, good chance you might be getting some type of cover two scheme, which is going to be five under, two deep. Okay, if the corners are off six or more, good chance you're going to be getting some type of robber quarters concept, okay? Robber quarters concept, all right, with the two split safeties. Now, how do you know which one's which and how do you tell? Look at the position of the outside linebacker. Most teams, if they're going to play robber or quarters, which means this backer is responsible for two to the flat, okay? A lot of times they will widen him and put him either head up to possibly outside your number two receiver. If he stays apexed in between your number two and the tackle, and he splits the difference of those two, there's a good chance that he's not responsible for two to the flat, okay? If your corner is responsible for two to the flat, okay, now there's a good chance that you can understand you're getting some type of quarters, two read, or possible, all right, robber concept, okay? Two read would have the corner to the flat, quarters robber would have this player to the flat. Now, some robber teams will play him, all right, a little bit wider, but they'll hang him in the curl, and your corner will still be responsible for the flat route, okay? But just in general, teaching coverages to your quarterbacks, teach them the deployment of the defense. Teach them one or two high safeties. Teach them where the corners are, all right? Now, the better football teams are going to play games with their corners. Yeah, we understand that, all right? Take a look at the outside linebacker. That'll give you a good understanding of whether you're getting some type of two deep, quarters, robber, okay, all right, some type of concept where he's inside of number two, okay? So right now we're looking at it as a standard two read like our defense plays, standard two read defense, okay? So what we understand right now, okay, what we understand right now is that this Sam linebacker is going to be the player, all right, that we want to put a conflict on with a 10-yard curl and a wide swing, all right? We want to make him define whether he's the curl defender or if he's going to expand, all right, with three. So that's the first conflict player we got, okay? So now the quarterback, if he doesn't get blitz, first thing he looks to is his blitz reads. If he doesn't get blitz, the first thing the quarterback has to understand is, what does this Sam do? If he sinks in the curl, I'm going to throw the hot swing with leverage. If he widens to the hot swing, I'm going to look to throw the curl, okay? All right, so again, Sam, does he sink in the curl or widen to the flat? That's the quarterback's read. Not hard to read off of that play. Now, after we've determined that, now we got to check and see what the Mike linebacker does. Hopefully, the Mike holds on the spot so we can throw the curl. If the Mike, for whatever reason, drops deep, Maybe it's a Tampa 2 team and he gets out of here, or he drops wide because of the tailback motion. He, for whatever reason, runs by the spot. Well, if he can affect the curl, then we're going to throw the spot. Okay? So first read is here. Hang or expand. If he hangs, we throw leverage. If he expands, we look to the curl route. That's the route we want to throw. Okay? Next is the Mike linebacker. Okay? Mike linebacker. All right? Does he sit on the spot? Let's go to the curl. Does he expand past the spot? Let's go to the check down. Okay? Now, while we're talking two read quarters of Robert principles, just make sure you understand now in this concept, the good football teams with active safeties, if two is under, this guy may be able to rob post-dig curl. Okay? So that's the next thing you got to talk to your quarterbacks about. Hey, look, I understand, all right, that the curl window is wide open and the Sam expand, all right, he expands out here to throw the curl. Be careful in quarters or two read, this guy may be able to rob post-dig curl. Okay? One of the things we do to protect that is we'll run curl post. All right, we'll take this number two vertical and get this safety out of here, and now we'll put all the pressure on the Sam linebacker if we think the Mike can't run wide enough to curl if it's a five-man box. So we'll run curl post, get him out, take him vertical. Now we can just sit and hammer this Sam linebacker that's right there. Okay? So not too hard of a concept, not that hard to understand. All right? The next thing is we show him one high. Okay? And before I show him one high, let me just show you... Let me just talk about one thing. You want to avoid, to the best of your ability, throwing curl slide concepts into cover two. Okay? The reason for that is if they deploy right, all right, they have every area covered if the defense defends right. When it's a hard cover two team, 5-2 deep, your corner's a flat player, so you're never going to leverage him with the swing. The Sam, if he's taught correctly, okay, and it's a 16-year-old kid, sometimes they're wrong, but if he's taught correctly, he will not expand with three because in cover two, he's a curl player. He doesn't have to worry about the swing of three. So he'll hang in the curl, okay? Corner will take the flat route coming back here. Your Mike linebacker drops to the side of number three and sits on the spot. All right, curl slide, curl spot concepts against cover two is not a good concept. So if you're getting two high safeties and you're getting cover two looks, all right, we're not going to talk about it today, but you want some type of other package in there because curl spot flat's not a good one. Okay? All right, now, if you were to get single high safeties, okay, love to play versus single high safeties. It's made a living on single high safeties, all right, for 40 years. Okay, now, if we're getting all five into the route, what we want to look at for the quarterback, okay, you are there to there for your hot protection. Play side inside linebacker, play side outside linebacker, okay? Your offensive line is going to turn it, and now they're going to turn it to the will, okay? They're going to turn it to the will, all right? So right now, offensive line's got the will. Now, what you're going to look at, strong safety, eight-man fronts, backside, okay? Strong safety, eight-man fronts, backside, 2x2. What I like to do if I'm getting eight-man fronts, one high, I will go to two-back, twins open, so that I can keep a back on the strong safety backside and still double-read front side. We don't side adjust off this player here. Okay, when we're talking about drop-back passing, we have other ways to handle this, but if we're dropping back, we don't side adjust here. Okay, so an eight-man front to a 2x2 situation for us gives us a little bit of a problem. I would go to two backs, leave a back in on the backside, and still run my same concept front side. For right now, we're just going to talk about the concept, one high, what we like to teach. Okay? So, front side. Play side inside, play side outside linebacker. All right? Either one of those come because it's a five-man protection. Okay? Five-man protection. Either one of those guys come, we got to throw the ball hot. Hot spot, hot swing. Okay? Hot spot, hot swing. Now, first thing we want to do is we want to put pressure. Conflict backer is the curl flat player in one high. They no longer have a player to rob the curl. So what we want to do is we want to leverage him with the hot swing, okay, with the wide swing flare route. Now we want to read. What is he going to do? Does he want to widen and expand with the swing route, or does he want to hang in the curl? If he hangs in the curl, we want to throw the ball to our back right now because we got him out leveraged. If he expands to the flat, our progression now becomes 1-2 on the spot because the Mike linebacker is the only guy left. Does the Mike sit on the spot or does the Mike drop to the curl? Okay? So when you're talking one high, cover three, all right? Possibly you could get man free. You don't see it a lot, but if you do see it, okay, man free is a little bit of an issue. I like to get the ball to the back in space and make them tackle them. All right? Got to understand there's other answers for man free than curl spot flat. Right now we're just talking curl spot flat. Cover three, one high, eight man front. Leverage the sand defender with the curl and with the wide hot swing. Pressure on a Mike linebacker with the spot and the curl. Okay, so if we were to get one high, our blitz protection would stay the same. It's either of these two, all right? Either of these two right now, all right? Either one blitz, ball goes hot spot, hot swing. If they don't blitz, pressure goes on the Sam. He expands, we look curl spot. He drops into curl, we go hot swing right now with leverage. Okay, so progressions. Teaching the quarterback to progress and understanding why he's progressing and understanding what the coverages are. Understanding why we like the route. I'm telling my quarterback, hey, one high teams, I love curl spot flat. If they're man free, then we'll go to something else. Well, coach, how do I know if it's man free? Do they chase your routes when you run them, or do they sit? Okay, man free, you run a spot, somebody's chasing a spot, all right? Unless they're a bracket team, and maybe he jumps this, the Mike jumps that, but man free, you'll see the corner hammer down on the curl route because he's not a deep third player. So when you're teaching your quarterbacks, well, coach, it's one high. I don't know if it's man-free or if it's zone. Well, do they chase routes or are they just dropping to spots? All right, that's one of the ways you teach your quarterback to determine whether it's zone or man. If they're chasing routes all over the field, it's a man concept. So it's one high, man-free. If they're dropping to spots, all right, it's a zone concept. And then they're going to match routes based on the deployment of your receivers. Okay, all zones turn to man eventually anyways if they're good defensive football teams. There are still some teams that will spot drop, and that's fine, but eventually, if teams don't want to just cover grass, they're going to learn how to match routes based on the deployment of your receivers. Okay? So if we get one high, we love the concept. Now, if it's eight-man front, I'll take this backside guy, and I'll put it back in the game, and I'll go to a two-back set, okay? And I'll just call, all right, protection. I'll just make a heavy call, and I'll keep that back on the backside. Now I've got, if they want to bring four from a side, I can block the four from a side they want to bring. My quarterback still has to be able, okay, to handle front side, all right? He's got to be able to handle front side double reads because we're getting three out to the front side, okay? Three out to the front side, all right? So you're going to say, well, coach, it's a six-man. You better the six-man into the protection. It's still three out to the front side for the quarterback. Okay, it's three out to the front side for the quarterback, all right? So he knows if it's tagged heavy, all right? He understands that it's still either one of those backers because we're getting three out front side with no front side player to double read on those linebackers, okay? Now, the next one is we can throw the concept out of play action, all right, simply by putting a back on the same side as the Twins receivers here, okay? And now we could run play action with a double read protection for the tailback. Now, I wouldn't do it against eight-man fronts because what am I going to lose here? I'm going to lose the backside guy if they bring four from a side. But if I knew they were split high safety teams, and I knew that I was always going to get, okay, if I knew I was always going to get split safeties, and I knew I was always going to get a Sam somewhere here, and I was always going to get a strong safety here with a free safety split backside and maybe a cover two principle. Well, now they can't bring eight. They can only bring seven. Okay? So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a six-man protection, and I'm going to make it both. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add a stay call to my tailback. Stay tells him play action, same side, all right, same side as the throw. So we would go play action inside zone or veer here, and now I would double read him to him, just like the quarterback does, okay? So now just by adding stay protection, now we've got curl, spot, my flat now becomes this fullback who leverages the flat at an aiming point of 6 yards to the sideline right now. That becomes your hot flat, hot swing route. He's not going to run swing from here. He's going to run arrow and leverage the flat right now. So I'm still going to get curl spot flat. I've got play action with the back. Now my quarterback knows that it's six-man protection because I made a stay call. And he knows that stay means the tailback is going to dual read with him. So now when we double read, both of these linebackers, again, six is both, they both have to blitz for me to get the football out of my hand. If they both don't blitz, I don't have to worry about getting the football out of my hand. All right? I understand that I can sit on one of these blitzes and still throw the football because I got helmets for helmets accounted for. And that's the big thing to teach a quarterback. When can you sit and know that blitzes were accounted for, and when do you have to get rid of the football? Now, blitzes accounted for doesn't mean there won't be pressure. But as a quarterback, you teach them, hey, look, we got helmets for those guys. Trust your teammates. Okay? Your quarterback needs to know where we have helmets for helmets so he can be tough in the pocket, and where he has to understand he doesn't have helmets for helmets and he's got to get rid of the football. Now, if we have helmets for helmets and a running back whiffs, quarterback gets sacked, you have to be able to tell your quarterback, hey, trust the protection. Running back whiffed on that. We'll fix it. He's got to know that he's not getting sacked because of free helmets, because then what's he going to do? As soon as he drops, he's going to get antsy and he's just going to take off. All right, he's going to get antsy and he's going to want to take off all over the place. So make sure your quarterback understands where his helmets are, how many he can protect. All right, big part of understanding what's going on with the curl slot. Okay, now 3x1. Okay, let's just say 3x1 now. All right, clean it up a little bit here. 3x1 is another formation for us. So let's just say we went into 3x1. All right, 3x1, and now we're going to get, all right, maybe Sam between 2 and 3, curl, strong corner, strong safety. Okay, Mike, Will, six-man box, corner, free safety back here, trying to determine whether he's going to spin to the middle on 3 vertical or if he's going to sit on the backside. We're still going to go curl, spot, flat. And now we bubble hot swing with 3. You can do it either way. You can back them up like a key screen. You can arrow them. Problem I have in high school is we have a problem when this guy's out here already leveraging a flat. It's great leverage. We have a problem making that throw. If you send him to the flat right now, it puts an immediate conflict on the Sam linebacker. The problem is we can't make that throw, all right, every year, year in and year out with our quarterbacks. So we'll bubble him to buy him time. We still get leverage out here, and that's a throw we feel like we can make. You can back him out like key screens, and that's a throw you should be able to make. This throw to 6 yards to the sideline here, that's a little bit different than this throw is. So you got to make sure you have the quarterback to throw that. So we go curl spot flat, okay, backside post here, all right? And in protection, it's all going to determine whether it's 1 high, 8-man front, what are they doing on the backside. If they're split safeties and they can't bring an extra guy, I'll go play action in here and dual read with the back, and we'll make a stay call. Okay, 6-man protection, they both have to blitz. Okay, 6-man protection, they both have to blitz. All right? If they're a team that likes to creep this free safety down on the backside, and maybe they can bring him and him, all right, then we'll make a tough call. All right, we'll make a tough call here. And tough tells the running back to go backside, okay, to account for the 8 guy coming off the edge. We'll be big on big, big on big, A gap, B gap, C gap. He takes the D gap. Quarterback has 1 to 2. Okay? So tough is 5-man protection. So now either of your play side inside linebacker to play side outside linebacker have to go, all right? Either one of those guys have to blitz. If either one comes, it's hot spot, hot swing. All right? So make sure you understand. Hot spot, hot swing, either one of those guys if it's tough. If it's stay and you're dual reading the tailback to both of those, then you got to know 6 men equals both. Same progression, curl, spot, all right, hot swing, flat. Make sure you understand what you're looking at, what they're trying to play on defense, how they're trying to defend that. All right, now one of the things I want to look at, we're going to take a look at some quarterback footwork now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the camera. All right, I'm going to drop the camera down a little bit so you can see, hopefully, most of my footwork, what I'm doing. We're going to talk about the three-step drop out of the gun for 5-step passes, talk about the footwork, talk about how we get depth and how we make the throws we want to make. Okay? All right, so I'm going to go a little bit wider here, and I'm going to drop the camera down so hopefully we can get all this on camera Sorry for the interruption, but we're off school today, and I've got two of my players out there that are looking to lift and run and do some other stuff. So, all right, right now what we're going to talk about is just the footwork that we go through with our quarterbacks. Now, again, understand dropping back and passing from the gun equates to a three-step drop from under center for the quarterback, okay? For us, there really are no five-step drops from the gun. That's going to put the quarterback 11 yards deep. Okay, there's really no need for that. You've already bought space from the line of scrimmage with the shotgun snap. Okay? You can't just stand there and throw the football because it doesn't time up with the routes. One of the things you got to understand is your routes that you run have to time up with the drop of the quarterback. All right? So when you're throwing a quick game and you're throwing three-step quick routes, which is one step in the gun, all right, your quarterback has to be able to take the football from here in the gun, push, and deliver the ball. Okay? Or he's got to go backside. All right, here's a quick coaching point. When you throw into your backside, pigeon your heel out. All right, pigeon your toe in, heel out to get your hips where they belong to the backside. So backside, it would be one. I turn my heel out so I can get my hips where they belong to the backside. When you're doing that, you had better be running some type of quick routes so that the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands times up with the receivers running their routes. If you're running drop back passing games, you have to be running some type of intermediate down the field route so the quarterback's drop times up with the routes that you're throwing so that he can throw receivers open, okay? Big thing is throwing guys open. What does that mean? All right, they talk all the time, the difference in maybe college guys, NFL guys. NFL guys throw guys open. The windows aren't as big, so they have to be able to throw guys open instead of just seeing a guy that's wide open and throwing to a window. Throwing a guy open means throwing before that receiver has made his break. Knowing what's going to be open based on the defensive coverage and throwing the ball before the receiver makes his break. So that if we're throwing curl slide or curl spot flat, and that outside linebacker widens to the hot swing, that quarterback's going to throw the curl before the curl breaks. All right? Because what that does is that buys time for the receiver now out of his break to catch the football and make people miss. Okay? If I wait for that receiver to run his curl and sit down in that window, then I deliver the ball, everybody is breaking. The safety might be robbing post a curl. The mic can run. The flat player that expanded can come back into the curl. So you have to understand how to throw people open. Okay? So let's look at the mechanics of the drop. First thing you're always going to teach your quarterbacks, just like you did if he was under center, put your mental weight on the foot, okay, that you're going to push off of. I am a right-handed player. Okay, my first step from the gun or the center is going to be with my right foot reaching for depth. Okay, so I want 70, 75%, 65% of my weight on my left foot. That's my mental weight. What that means is pre-snap, I want that weight leaning a little bit to that side because I know that I want to push and reach off that side. Okay, so my mental weight is on my left foot. All right, I want to get this ball, and the first thing I want to do is I want to reach. Okay, reach, all right? Now, that used to be huge under the center because I had to get depth from the line, all right? I already have depth from the line. I'm going to add some depth here, all right? But I'm also going to work my footwork to put me in position to throw the football and time the routes up. You get quarterbacks, and I've had my guys do this, they don't reach first. They go here. Well, we're running 10-yard curl. We're running spot swing. We haven't leveraged anybody. Nobody's ready to receive the football. Okay, so it's important that they understand that I want to reach first, all right, not only to add some depth from the line of scrimmage, but also to time up the drop in the routes that we're running. So the first one is always going to be mental weight on my left foot, okay, mental weight on my left foot, push and reach, okay, push and reach. Now, one thing we don't have to worry about anymore is seating the ball, then loading the ball. When you used to have under center quarterbacks, you used to have to tell them how to seat the ball because they were close to all the traffic. And if somebody whiffed up front and got in, you wanted that ball protected. So you used to have to work on seating the ball first and then loading it second. Well, when you're in the gun and you're away from all that, we don't have to worry about seating it. So we can take the football and load it where we want right away. All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we're just going to push and reach. And I'll just take my quarterback. Sometimes I'll stand on their plant foot. All right. Snap them a ball, reach, get depth, reach, okay? So we'll work that over and over. I'll stand on their foot and make them reach, okay? Then I start them in the reach. The last two steps of a drop, whether it be three-step, five-step, seven-step, under-center shotgun, the The last two steps of a quarterback drop will always be short crossover plant. Short crossover plant. All right? Big teaching point that I use with my QBs, and I used to use when I taught first year as a GA in college. I played receiver. Coach gives me quarterbacks. Sorry, my second year as a GA. Coach says, you're going to take the quarterbacks. You can handle the quarterback a little bit better than I can. Because the quarterback was my quarterback when I was a senior. He was a freshman. So I said, all right, coach, well, what am I going to do? All right, go to clinic, study it up. Big point I picked up. On the short crossover step, try and tell your quarterbacks to try and kick themselves in the shin with their heel. So if I'm reached here as a right-handed quarterback, on the short crossover, I want to try and take my left foot and kick myself in the shin. All right? Kick my right shin right now. Okay? So I'd be reached, and I would just have my quarterbacks work on the reach, short crossover, kick. Kick yourself in the shin. What that's going to do is that's going to put my foot short crossover where it belongs, okay? As opposed to like a big, all right, hurdlers or a karaoke, as opposed to that step, it's kick in the shin, kick. So I would take him from the reach position and go, hey, short crossover, kick. Short crossover, kick. Short crossover, kick, okay? Off the short crossover, now we want to make a plant step because that's the foot that we're going to get in the ground and be ready to throw the football. So then I would go reach, short crossover, plant. Okay? Air under your heels, balls of your feet lively, not standing flat foot. Okay, so it'd be reach, here, ball loaded, ready to go, short crossover, plant. Alright? Reach, start them in the reach position. Short crossover, plant. Ready to go. Okay? Put them all together, it would look like reach, short crossover, plant, balls of your feet, ball loaded, ready to go. Okay, reach, short crossover, plant, balls of your feet, ready to go. Okay, after you've worked the drops, I always teach them step by step. Reach first, short crossover, plant, put them all together. Okay, don't just put a drop in and say, hey, go ahead and drop. Next thing you're always going to want to do, all right, footwork with your quarterback in the pocket. Okay. Universal drill, everybody does it. Shuffle, shuffle, up, get out, throw a ball. All right, what you're going to do is you're going to put your quarterback in a drop, and then you're going to give him directions with a thumb, and you're going to make him step, 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 okay? Coaching point, always move the back foot first so that you're in position to throw the football, okay? So that when I get in my position where I'm ready to throw here, and coach starts doing that drill, if he points that direction, I want to go back, front, back, front, back, front, back, front, back, front, okay? Always want to move my back foot first, okay? Do the drill with the quarterback. I do it with them. Make them drop. They're looking at me. I say, hey, this way, back foot, up to me. That means step up in the pocket, okay? Because when you finish your drop, your five-step drop on the curl spot flat progression, what's going to happen is you're going to finish your drop here. Now, as you progress, you're not just going to sit right here. You're going to start working up into the pocket, slowly. Back foot, front foot, back foot, waiting for those routes to progress so you can throw somebody open. Okay? Now, along the course of that, what may happen is you're waiting for the curl and there's pressure here and I got to step this way. Or there's inside pressure. I'm here and the three technique spike, the guard's running them hard. I had to step up, okay, out of the pressure. Stay in the pocket as long as you can, okay? The last thing we do with that drill is I give them a finger side to side, which means evade, okay? If I'm a right-handed quarterback, front side, if the coach gave me evade, I would get depth, evade to my front side, depth and evade to my front side, now it becomes a sprint out drill. If the coach gave me a finger to my back side, all right, I'm gonna turn my back and spin. If there's pressure coming from here, you don't want to open back into the pressure. So if there's pressure coming from your backside that a good quarterback starts to feel, what you want to do is you want to spin out of that pressure, make that guy go under, okay, and get depth, all right? So it would be, I'd be here, pressure backside, spin out, and now sprint out to my left. So spin out of it, pressure backside, the worst thing to do is open back into that pressure and get ear hold. So your good quarterback that starts the field, he's got his feet going, pressure, spin, he spins out. So that would be thumb, shuffle, 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 spin out, spin out. Always end it with a throw. Clap your hands, do whatever you want. Have your reads out there. Make them do all those shuffle drills, okay? Clap your hands and have three receivers on the ground. Curl route, spot route, swing route, okay? Clap your hands, and one of those guys pops up. So now your quarterback goes through the drills, okay? He steps up, he steps back, he steps up. You clap your hands, and now a ball comes. Curl, spot, wherever that ball is, I now have to get my hips and shoulders in position to throw the football, okay? So, you know, simple drills you can work on. Give them curl, spot, flat. Make them do drops. Clap your hands. One receiver stands up. I stand behind him and I point. So I'll clap my hands and point to the spot. Clap my hands and point to the curl. Clap my hands and point to the swing. That receiver that I point to pops up, shows a target. So now the quarterback is going through his footwork. He's doing all his drills. He's stepping up. And now somebody pops up. And now I've got to be able to turn and throw flat. Pops up on the spot. Throw the spot. Pops up on the curl. Okay, I was back here. Curl. Step and throw the curl. Okay, so again, progressions that you're working on. Teaching your quarterback on the board, routes, coverages, who are we leveraging? Okay, what do different coverages take away? Why do we like curl flat versus this, but we don't like it versus that? What's your hot protection? Then you're getting him on the field, you gotta teach him his footwork. Footwork is most important in the passing game for a quarterback. Okay, too many people look at arm strength, position of the wrist, the elbow up. That's all important, don't get me wrong. But if your quarterback doesn't have feet, he's never going to be a good player. Okay? I'm a huge Dan Marino fan. I think Dan Marino is the best thrower of the football that ever lived, period. Not saying best quarterbacks, he didn't win Super Bowls, but he would have on different teams. Getting the football out of his hand from point A to point B and manipulating the pocket. Dan Marino could not run. He had some of the best, livest feet in the pocket. Peyton Manning in the pocket is a genius. Okay? Can't run. You know he can't run. But he manipulates that pocket. Why? Because they work on it. Short, quick feet. Intermediate drills, learning how to move in the pocket. Learning how to reset the pocket based on where the pressure is coming from. So you start in the classroom and you teach your routes, you teach your progressions, you teach your protection. Okay? You move on from there, and now when you get to your quarterback, you start teaching drops. And you don't just drop right away. You teach them how to reach first. Then you teach them short crossover, kick yourself in the shin. Then you teach them short crossover plant, balls of your feet, live. Then you teach them drops into footwork. Then you teach them drops into footwork, throw these different routes. Then you put it all together, okay? All right, so it's a whole part, whole teaching concept, okay? Chalk, talk, walk, all right, teaching concept, where you're gonna talk about it on the board in the off season with your kids. Notes and sessions with your quarterbacks. Okay, guys, here's our curl spot flat. Here it is at a 2x2. Here it is at a 2-back. Here it is at a 3x1. Here's your routes. Here's your backside progressions. Here's your protection. Okay, now when we get on the field, let's work on drops. All right, before we ever worry about throwing those routes, let's worry about getting in position to throw them. Okay, and anytime during that drop, if it's hot, get it in the ground and throw hot. You don't have to finish your drop, okay? If you reach and you got your eyes on your reads and that mic shows off your reach now, set your feet and throw hot, swing, hot spot. You don't always have to finish your drop, all right, in the drop back passing game. If you approach it that way and you break it down, how to teach your quarterback the fundamentals of what your routes are, what your protections are, who his hot reads are, okay, what his footwork is, now, what the timing of the routes is, then you go out and throw with your kids to work on timing. You can't throw, and you can grab guys in the offseason and say, hey, these quarterbacks work all year throwing routes. They know each other like the back of their hand. You can't work timing until you work footwork and drops, okay? Because those intermediate 10-yard concepts, five-step drop concepts that are shuffle, okay, these are not five-step foot in the ground, throw the bang eight, skinny post, okay? So in other words, this is not reach, short crossover, plant, bang eight. This is a progression concept. So it's here, shuffle, now wait and throw somebody open. Those time up with your routes, all right? Those time up with your routes. So if you're asking a kid to make a 22-yard bang eight post throw, you may not want to have him shuffling up to throw the bang eight because it's too late. All right, that would be a situation where it's, hey, reach, short crossover plant, bang the eight, post route right now. These are All right, these are hitch and hold, if you want to call them. All right, quarterback terminology, hitch and hold. Okay, when you get to the end of your drop, this means finish your drop, and now you've got a hold in position to throw the football. Okay, then you can progress to the ball's high, the ball's low, it's here, it's there. All right, let's look at the wrist position. Let's look at the elbow position. Are we lead with the elbow first? Let's look at the grip on the ball. Are we choking it? Do we have air in the pocket? Let's look at where your fingers are. Does your index finger come off last? Are you snapping it down to the opposite thigh board? All right, and turning it over? Are you throwing baseball curveballs? Do you have your wrist cupped under? Those are all things you can progress to and get to with your quarterback. If he doesn't understand route concepts and protection and he doesn't understand footwork, don't worry about all that stuff he does with his arm. He's never going to be a good player. You can work on all those other things, okay? Watch Phillip Rivers throw the football and somebody tell me that all his mechanics are in the right position. Somehow he's one of the best quarterbacks in the AFC for the last 10 years, but he's got some of the worst mechanics you ever see. He looks like Dan Quisenberry from the 82 Royals throwing the football sidearm and underarm. Another thing you have to understand as a quarterback, all right, drills, you got to understand there's almost no clean throws in dropback quarterbacks. In other words, all your throws usually involve traffic and step. A lot of them are short step throws, okay? You almost never get a chance to sit in the pocket, stride, deliver, okay? That's almost never going to happen for you. So what you got to understand is you got to be able to do some short step, you know, almost no step throws sometimes where you got to throw hot swing from here and you got to throw it, all right, as is, all right? You got to understand that there are no easy pocket throws to teach your quarterback. There's always going to be hands up. There's always going to be traffic. He's got to understand how to manipulate the traffic, how to work his footwork. So you can't always work on the ideal situations because football is not an ideal game. I do agree you can teach your kids to throw better with proper mechanics. I don't argue that. I never have. Okay? I do agree that you got to work on mechanics. I also agree that every kid throws the football different. Every pitcher and every quarterback throws the football different. Okay? Find what your kid does well. Fine-tune his mechanics from there. Every quarterback has the same type of footwork. Okay, so if there's one standard in the NFL you can look at, it may not be elbow position, it may not be wrist, it may not be grip on the ball. But you look at footwork in their drops and you're going to see 99% of the guys with the same mechanics. That's one thing that is always the same. So rep that, then worry about where the ball comes out and how it comes out later. Okay, hopefully I did a good job for you guys explaining curl spot flat. Hopefully you can understand it a little bit better. All right, another video on YouTube. You guys that are subscribers, love it. Thanks. Next blog this week is going to be on up-tempo football and how to do an up-tempo drill. Now that we're getting in and ready for our spring football in a month, we'll talk about how we teach an up-tempo drill with our players. All right, I'll check you guys out next time. Thanks for watching.